This is what I would call a fill-in-the-angle problem. The first thing I always advise students to do in a problem like this is make sure they know which angle they're looking for. I'm trying to figure out the measure of angle DEF, so I'm going to maybe put like a little arrow there and put a question mark. All right, let me move that little weird icon off of there. All right, so we want to find that angle. Now, what do we know? Well, most of what they've told us, they've already marked in the drawing. For instance, 111 degrees there, 39 degrees there. They did tell us that EF is perpendicular to DFC, and that tells me that this angle is 90 degrees. Ah, now that's good, because that 90 degree angle is contained in the same triangle, right, that the angle that I'm looking for is contained in. So if I could just simply find this angle, right, angle EDF, right, this one right here, if I can find that, then all I have to do is subtract that this one from 90, or add that one to 90 and subtract from 180, and I'll find the one that I want. Well, what else do I know? I know that this figure is a parallelogram, and one of the things I should have learned about parallelograms is that two consecutive angles are supplementary. In other words, the measure of angle ABC, right, the measure of angle ABC is 180 degrees minus 111 degrees, or 69 degrees. So this entire angle from here to here